Hey, science seekers. What's up, guys? How we doing? All right, we're in Mr. Pfeiffer's yard again. Today's lesson is about biology. We're going to go ahead and talk a little bit about plants today. So I'm going to take you through a little bit of my garden. We're going to do this a few times because it's important to understand kind of how plants work. They're another big kingdom. We did fungi the other day. So let's talk about some plants. All right, I'm going to go through and show you a couple of things here. All right, these are what we call saplings. Saplings traditionally come up, and they're basically another word for a baby plant, all right? Saplings traditionally are smaller, and you will see they'll have very light roots, and they're not the full adult plant. You got a seed, eventually that seed becomes a sapling, and then those saplings eventually become full-grown plants. This is a full-grown plant. These are getting ready to come out soon. These are a very common spring plant. Okay, these are known as daffodils, and the flower is going to be coming out of this little head right here very soon. When something flowers, it means that it's going to be creating its reproductive parts so that it can make more of itself later. So remember, inside the flower, which we'll learn about when these flower, I'll show you, there's different parts, and you have the boy and the girl parts, just like in any other thing that reproduces sexually. These are another good one. You can see they're different than what we saw before. These plants, along with, let's see if we can find my favorite. One of my favorite plants is an iris, all right? Irises grow on the roots with bulbs, like this. This is an old root, but they come off of the roots and grow. And often they like shallow ground, and they like it to be nice and watery. So because it's so wet outside right now, these are the first plants you'll see in the springtime. Now you'll see a lot more plants coming out later on in the year. Different plants bloom at different seasons. So April showers bring May flowers, and these are some of the flowers that we will be seeing in May because of those great showers, the first signs of spring. Have a great day today, kids. Good luck with your missions.